Hi, this is Niharika Arora and welcome to the intermediate track. In the previous session, we have just started building Book My Show application clone, and I hope you had a great time building the application. Right now, we just have an Android project with basic layout files added. So today, me and my co-speaker Shreyank are going to take the application to the next level. So in today's session, we will implement Android Recycler View, which will basically display a list of movies, and then we will implement a HTTP library retrofit, which will help us to connect our application to a RESTful web services. And don't worry, when you hear big words, we'll explain everything shortly. So let's begin with the presentation. Okay. So now, what exactly do we mean by Recycler View? What is it all about? So almost every app in our device is having at least one list of data sets to show to the users. Like if I talk about Contacts app, where we have a list of all our contacts, the Music app containing a list of all our songs and our playlist, etc. Myntra or Flipkart showing a list of products, and we have InShorts as well, which is an app showing a list of all the news happening around, right? So these are just few examples. And now to handle a bunch of data in our app and show that efficiently, Android has provided us with something, and that something is Recycler View. So, well, if I talk in Android words, Recycler View is nothing but a view group that is used to display large data sets in the form of either a list or grid. So Recycler View can exist in various forms. It can display a list of items in one dimensional list. And for this, we use a special class, which is Linear Layout Manager with Recycler View. We can present data. And such structure is made possible using Grid Layout Manager. Great. Okay, so now with that, we can also present items based on the size of the image or the content we have. So basically, you are allowed to display items in a way you want to. And this is possible through Staggered Grid Layout Manager. And now you have seen different type of layout managers, and which is basically helping us in figuring out how we need to display the items on the screen. Now to implement Recycler View, we need to have an adapter which will bind data with the views on the screen itself. And for that, we use RecyclerView.adapter class. And now what is the purpose of using this adapter class exactly? And whenever I hear this adapter word or anyone hear this adapter word, we actually get to the charging adapter we use for our devices, isn't it? So your adapter just knows its work of charging your devices like laptops, mobile phones, etc. It doesn't care about the type of socket or plugs we are having, and it just adapts to work nicely with any environment you provide. And well, in the same way, if we talk in the Android world, adapter knows nothing about the origin of the data source. Its only work is to help Recycler View in showing the data to the users by managing both the data as well as the views there. Let me give you an example for this. So let's assume this is a Recycler View. So the role of adapter is to bind data to the views for each row item. And we have this city object here that basically contains an image resource and a string name. And we have a layout here. We can see that on the screen itself. So the adapter is going to create a view object out of this layout and bind the city object to it. So once we bind data to the view, we can present it on screen using Recycler. And the same process is repeated by the adapter for all the row items, other row items we have. And in this way, Recycler View is able to display all items on screen using the adapter. Nice and simple. So now, let's start implementing Recycler View in our Book My Show clone application. We'll implement Recycler View in step-by-step process so that you don't get overwhelmed. Our first step will be to prepare a data set to display in each row of the list. and for that we'll create a data class of movie, and this movie class will contain a few properties, as like we will be having the movie name, poster URL, release date, total votes, and based on those total votes, what is the average movie rating. Sound simple? So yeah, okay. But right now, we will be fetching the data locally, and later Shriyank will show how you get that data from the server itself and display in this recycler. Okay, let's switch to our Android screen now. Before we move ahead, you should have your project up to date. And if you are attending the workshop from today onwards, then you must check out the intermediate branch from the GitHub, and link is given in the description. So just make sure we are on the same page. All right. For the data sets, I want you to first download the GIST files, and link is again in the description. And I have already downloaded mine. So now, this file will basically all the movies, and will you can see some image relative image URL paths. Then we have some other list as the name of the release dates, the titles, vote average, and you can also see a list property which has a custom getter, and this getter will provide us with the required data set. Fine. So now, moving back to the presentation. So we will be preparing .layout resources for us. We have to add the recycler view in the activity main XML, and then what we will do is we will have a movie item layout for showing all the items in the recycler view, right? So now, coming back to the Android. Here we can see that main XML is already view and is already in play. Okay, so now what we need to do is we need to have a movies adapter class, which will be basically a subclass of our recycler view dot adapter, and with that what we need to have is we will be having the movies view holder class, which basically as the name signifies, view holder is nothing but this is there for holding all the views, and this will help us in binding all the data and the views within and show them in the recycler views. So this is the role of view holders with us. So coming back to the Android screen. Okay, so now let's create this movies adapter class. Let's have one. Okay, so now I am having this movies adapter class. I hope you have also created it. After that, now within this class, let's create a view holder, a movies view holder. This class should extend from the recycler view holder class. But before that, this movies view holder will be having the view reference here. So we'll add a view object as parameter here, and we'll this view extend it from recycler view dot view holder, and this view holder as to its superclass. Now what we'll do is, after doing all these things, we have our view object, right? And let's create a function to combine our data with this view object. Let me create that function. This is name it as bind, and I will be passing the movie object from which we will be getting all the properties which we need to set in our views. Okay, so now we have the item view, right? Let me show you something here. With item view, you can see some suggestions here, right? So you can have your view references, view ID references here. I am having this movie title, right? Now, with Kotlin, we have Kotlin Android extensions. these are just nothing. We just have plugins which will generate some extra code, and that will allow you to access the views in the layout XML. As just if there are some properties with the name of the IDs we have used in the layout definition. As you can see here, I'm having these names and I can easily access them through Kotlin Android extension plugins. Right? So what I will do is I will be setting the text here and I will get the movie dot title. Cool? Okay. So now in this way, we will be going to bind all our other views and with this data. Let me do that. So we have other views like release date. I'll be setting the text and movie dot release date. Then I have this item view dot other properties we have is average voting dot text. I'll be setting the text from movie dot the vote average we have, right? Now you can see some error here and it says that we have a type this mismatch here, and I am just showing some text. So what I can do is I will just do the string conversion here. And other property we have is the total votes, right? Let me set the text here. We have the movie dot total votes, vote count. And again, we have this string, this mismatch for the types, and I will just do the same thing here. Okay, great. So now we have set the text here. Now to display movie posters in the image, we'll use Glide library. And I think you have already added the dependency for that. You have already added the dependency in the previous session, right? You can see here. Okay, so now let me use that. With Glide, we have a method with, and in which what we'll do is we have to pass a context. And I will be passing the view context here. And now with that, what you need to have is we have the load method. And in load method, you can pass URI or URL. And we have the URL, relative URLs in our movie.kt file, what I will do is I will be taking the movie.poster path and showing it into I need to give the reference for the view, the image view here. So I will be getting that here, from here, a movie poster, right? Now, as if you remember, when I was talking about the movie.kt file, I have taken this relative path here, right? So what I need to do is I need to add the base URL also. So for that, you can find the base URL in your gist, and I will just copy paste mine. You can see an error here, which says that constant val are only allowed on top level on an object. So you can't have them in classes like this. And for that, as we have public static final in Java, we have in Kotlin, we have companion object in which we can put it the same way and use the constants here. Okay, so what I will do is for each image loading, I will just append the image base URL. Okay, great. So now our movies adapter class should receive the data sets from the main activity, right? And for that, let me create a constructor that receives movies list of objects. So what I will do is I will add a list as a parameter in the constructor. Let me name that as movies and add it here. A list of movie we are expecting, right? Also, now this is an adapter class and this needs to be extended from recyclerView.adapter class. So I am adding the adapter here, and this needs a view holder. So what I can do is I can add the movie view holder here. Okay, great. So now you can see that we are getting this error. So you need to implement the methods here, and I can press the Alt Enter, and I can see that I have to implement the members of the adapter class. You can just select all and press OK, and you will get all the methods. Now, as for readability, what I can do is I will put them above my view holder. Okay, so now we have all the methods here. This get item count, you can see all the methods, and this get item count is nothing. It is just showing us all the list count. Basically, we have the movies list, and we are showing the count of the movies. So I will return that here. Okay. For any kind of method which is returning a single expression, we can use this equal operator, and we can just omit those curly braces. Okay, great. So now another method is onCreateViewHolder, and with that we let's write some code there. Now the purpose of this onCreateViewHolder is to create the required views objects which will be used to display the items on the screen. Basically, coming back to the presentation, okay, so now there are some important property that I want to discuss about onCreateViewHolder basically. So with onCreateViewHolder, we have 1,000 movie items, right? And so it doesn't mean that onCreateViewHolder is going to create 1,000 view holder objects. So to save memory, onCreateViewHolder is going to create only a limited number of view holder objects, and those number of view holder objects it will create will depend on the items visible on a screen at a time. And these limited view holder objects so created will be recycled and reused as a user scrolls up and down on the within the list. Fine. So yeah, here you can notice that recycling view has actually got its name due to its recycling behavior. And so I hope it makes sense to you now how recycler view has got its name. Nice and simple, right? Let's switch back to our Android screen now. Okay, so let me write some code here. I will be having the view. We have the layout inflator, which basically helps us in inflating the view which we want. Method, and I will be passing the context here, the parent.context, and I am using the inflate method, and I will pass the layout which I want to inflate for all the items. And that is movie item layout, the main view group, which is our parent itself. And I don't want this to be attached to the root, so I can make it false. And what I will do is I will return the movie view holder with this view reference. Right? So now, as you can see, that this will pass, this movie view holder is having this view reference, and this will be used while binding the data with the movie data, with the movie object. This. Okay, so now we are left with our onBind view holder, right? So as you can see that onBind view holder, as the name implies, it will bind data to each view object that we are going to create in onCreateViewHolder method, right? Now, the method will be called for each item present in the list, and that is for each position. As you can see the position here, so we will be binding the data for each position. So what I need to do is, as we have the holder reference here, I will call this bind method. And what I will do is, I have the movies list and I will pass the position for which I need to bind the data. Perfect. So yeah, on bind view holder. Now, as you can see, so within this method and on this view holder object, we are calling the bind method and passing the movie object for this position. So holder.bind method will call the bind method defined here and within this movie view holder class, and thus will bind data to each widget. Great, isn't that? Okay, we are done with the adapter class. Our last step is to link the adapter with a recycler view, and in this step where we can also add a layout manager to a recycler view. So coming back to my main activity, within this onCreate method, let me call a function movies. Let's name it as show movies, and I will be passing a list of movies. Create this function. We have this array list, and let me have this in simple way. So now we have this show movies function. Two is in within this method. Let us use recycler view, which we have from our activity main XML, and call the set adapter method so that we can set the adapter which we have created. We can call the adapter for it. And now this movies adapter will take your list. Let me name it. Let me have a meaningful name. So we can have this movies here, and I'm just passing movies to it, right? So you should have some, there shouldn't be a null value here. So you can, I'm just adding a not null thing here. With Kotlin, we have this. So showing that you are not having null value, it is just ensuring that. And as we are having the data statically, so we can assume that, right? For now. Now, let me add some other properties, a few more line of codes. We have recycler view, and with that, let me call this set has fixed size as true. And another is recycler view dot item animator, and I am setting that item animator as default item animator. Now the statement set has fixed view set to true, this will notify recycler view that the recycler view items has a fixed width and height, and it won't change even if the adapter's content is getting changed. You told recycler view to not calculate item size every time they are getting added or removed from it. So this will allow recycler view to perform some performance optimizations internally, I can say. And this property item animator is basically for, you can set some animations. And by default, we have this default animation set to the recycler view. And this will be effective when we are adding or deleting an item from the recycler view. So good thing is that you can now create your own custom animations and use them with recycler views easily and efficiently. Fine. So yeah, these two statements are generally used while initializing the recycler view. Now, what about the layout managers? As you can see with recycler views, what we have done is we have set the layout manager itself. We have this layout manager, and I want to show the items vertically here. So I am setting the orientation as vertical, right? Okay. So what we need to do is we need to have this recycler view dot visibility set to visible, right? You can set the progress bar whenever we are showing the list. We can just set the visibility for that as gone, right? Now let's run our application. you can see the name, average count, day, release date, etc. But you can't see the images, right? For now, for images, as we have to load them from the internet, what we need to do is we need to add the permission here. We need to have the internet permission, right? Let me do this again. Let's run again. Here we go. So yeah, now we have got the recycler view, which is displaying a list of movies, the name, images, total counts, everything is here, right? So well, right now these movie data sets are statically coming from the project, right? And but in professional applications, this data will actually come dynamically from the server. So my co-speaker Shriyank will now walk you through how to fetch data from the server using Retrofit and display it using Recycler. So over to you, Shriyank.
So thank you, Niharika, for such a great explanation. Well, so friends, right now, well, before that, let me introduce myself. I am Shriyank Siddharth. I am an Android developer and author at Pluralsight. So let's move to our application. And right now in our application, if you notice, we have implemented the Recycler view, right? And in that Recycler view, we are actually displaying the list of movies from the local data source. So my intention is to replace that local data source and fetch all the movies data from the web server. So basically, we are going to connect our application to the server. But before we proceed, let me ask you a question. Why do we need to connect our application to the web server? What is the need for that? So, well, in our day-to-day life, we all use applications like Facebook, Instagram, Amazon, Flipkart, and so on and so forth, right? And whenever we open the Facebook application, our expectation is to watch all the fresh content from our friends or relatives, right? The new post and new stories. For example, also, if we open the Flipkart application, we want to see a new list of products. Well, the same thing is applicable. We are going to implement in our application as well. We are going to implement. Yeah, next slide. Yeah, we are going to make use of a special library known as Retrofit that will enable our application to send a HTTP request to the server. And the server in response is going to send us back the HTTP response object. And using that response object, we will make use of the Retrofit to display data on our Recycler view, right? So the process is very simple, and don't worry, you don't have to set up your web server. We are going to make use of a ready-made server, which is the TMDB movie server. So yes, let's move to our next step. Yeah, so before we start, we have to make sure in our project, we must add the dependency for Retrofit. And along with that, we have to add a few permissions, which Niharika has already added, but let me walk you through that again. So if you go to your Gradle file, module level Gradle file, here at the bottom within dependencies, you will find we have already added the dependency for Retrofit. And along with this, we have added the dependency for JSON library. So what exactly is a JSON library? Well, when the server send us back the HTTP response object, then that response object contains a JSON file. And using that JSON file, we are going to extract some data and use it in our project, right? So the role of JSON is to convert, map those JSON data into our own data classes and back and forth. And this JSON library is actually used by Retrofit library. So they both are integrated together to work together. And if you go to your manifest file, then here, as Niharika has already added this internet permission, so it is already in place. And I suggest you to add this second permission of access network state. So what is the actual purpose of this permission? Well, access network state basically allows you to access all the information about the internet connection. In short, it actually checks whether your device has active internet connection or not. So yes, this was it for this step. Okay, so now that we are done with that step, the project setup, our next step will be to prepare the data classes, such as we are going to make use of the movie data class And along with this, we are going to make use of movie response data class. Yeah, so within our project, if you notice within the main package, we already have movie.kt file where we have our data class of movie and we have the object declaration of movies where we stored all the static data. So let me remove all these static data because we will be fetching data from the server, right? And what is the purpose of having this data class? Let me show you shortly. But before that, let me show you the actual JSON file that we are going to receive from the movies DB server. So basically, this is the URL to which we are going to make the GET request. Now, if you take a look at our JSON file, it contains at the root level JSON object. This is a JSON object. Then we have a few key value pairs, and then we have results JSON array. And this JSON array contains a lot of JSON objects, such as this is one object, this is another object, this is third object, and so on and so forth. We have more objects. So basically, each object represents details of one particular movie, such as this is one movie, this is another movie, and so on, right? So out of these fields of the movie details, we are going to extract a few details, such as ID of the movie, then title of the movie, release date, vote average, poster path, then popularity, the vote count, right? So if you take a look at our data class, we have five properties in place. And along with this, we have to add one more property of the ID, which is of the type integer, right? Now, the name of these properties should be exactly same as the key which is actually present in your JSON file, such as poster underscore path. But as per the Kotlin naming convention, it is the snake is naming convention, right, which violates the Kotlin naming convention. So in retrofit, we have a provision for that. We can name the property as per our wish, but instead you have to use annotation of serialized name. Let's use it. And then as a parameter, you have to pass the key such as poster underscore path, like this. And the same thing is applicable for the property such as release date. So here you have to use the snake is names. Then for vote average, you have to do the same thing. And finally, the vote count. Now for the properties such as title and ID, if you notice, these two names matches exactly same as that of the keys present here, right? So these two are good enough for our purpose. So we don't have to use any annotation here. So our next step will be to create one more data class, which will be movie response. Let's convert it into a data class, and its property will be results, which will be of the type of list of movie. Great. So what exactly we are doing here? Well, if you notice, at the root level, we are receiving the JSON object, right? And within this JSON object, we have the results array. So basically, this root level JSON object will be mapped to this movie response data class object. And within this, the results array will be mapped to this list of movie property, right? So that's why the name of this results is exactly the same as this results over here. So I hope you get it. Yes, so now that we are done with the data classes, our next step will be to prepare the interface. And using that interface, we are going to define a few functions that will be responsible to create a GET request, POST request, PUT, PATCH, and DELETE request. And we are going to name that file as movieservice.kt. Now, right after this, we are going to initialize our retrofit within a special class of retrofit builder. So we are going to make that file. Okay. So let us move to our next step. And here within our main package, we need to create an interface. Let's call it movie service. Select interface. So now within this, we will create a function of getMovies, which will return a call object. This call object belongs to this retrofit2. Please select this one. And as a generic type, we are going to pass the movie response, because the root JSON object will be mapped to this movie response data class, right? And using this function, we want to create a get request. So for that, we can use a special annotation of @get. And then within this, I will add a relative URL, such as discover/movie. Now, this relative URL is basically a part of our final URL which we desire to build, such as discover/movie. And at the end of this URL, after a question mark, we are having a query parameter of API key and the token, right? So within this function, as a parameter, we have to use the annotation of @query. And then as a parameter, pass the string of API_key. And then define a property. Great. So this was all about this movie service interface. Now, moving on to our next one. Within the main package, let us create a new Kotlin file and call it retrofit builder. Then select object, because we are going to make it as an object declaration, where we will store some data, such as our first data will be to add the base URL, right? And for that, I will make use of the gist files. Well, these are the gist files that you will get from the link in the description. So make sure you just download it. And from this url.txt, you will find this base URL. You just need to copy it, which I will copy from here, and paste it over here. And then our next step will be to create a OKHTTP client instance. I will use the builder and then use the build function. Now next, we are going to create a JSON instance. Let us import it. And then finally, I will create a retrofit instance. So for that, I will use private val retrofit equal to, I will call retrofit dot builder, and then use build function. Now to this retrofit, I am going to add a few properties, such as I will add the base URL, dot base URL. It's a function where we will pass this base URL, and then I will add a converter factory that will attach or integrate the JSON which we have created over here, right? So for that, I will use JSON converter factory, which is a special class dot create and pass the JSON instance. Quite simple, isn't it? And finally, I will attach the OKHTTP client by using the client function. Now, let me get back to this base URL. Well, if you notice, this base URL, when combined with this relative URL, along with this query parameter of API key, is going to give you this complete URL. So I hope you understand from where does this complete URL is coming from, right? And then within retrofit builder at the bottom, I will create a function which will return the instance of this movie service interface, right? Because we have to ultimately use this interface in our application to make the API call. So yes, for that, I will define a function that is, it will build the service, which will return movie service, of course. and then it will return retrofit dot create function, call it, and then pass movie service class.java. Right. So once you call this function, it is going to return the instance of a class that implements this interface. Right. Now, before we move to our next step, I would like you to go to your gist files and copy this network helper.kt file. And then I will paste it within the main package. And this file, you will get it from the gist files. Again, link is in description. Well, what is the purpose of having this network helper? Well, in any professional application, if you make use of internet connectivity, then you would need this file. Well, don't worry about the complication of this, of the code written over here. Just I will give you a gist of what this function do. Well, this file contains a function is network connected. So if you call this function, then this function is simply going to return either true or false. If your device is connected to the internet, this function will return true. Otherwise, it will return false. Fine, very simple, right? So back to presentation. So now that we have interface in place, we have created the instance of retrofit as well. So from our UI layer, that is our main activity, we are going to start making the HTTP RESTful API call to the server, right? So back to Android Studio. Let us go to our main activity. So here, what I will do is our first step will be to create a function fetch movies. So let's create this function first. Create function fetch movies over here within this file. And then our first step will be to check for the active internet connection. So I will use if we are connected to internet. So for that, I will make use of network helper. Well, I should create an instance of it, right? So what I will do is I will use, network helper and pass the instance of this. And then I will use network helper dot is network connected. So if we are connected to the internet, then make API call, else we have some error. So in that case, we will display some error message. Now, before we begin, I would like to add a few utility function in this file. So in that case, again, I will go to my notes here. You can get type the code yourself just to save some time. I'm copying it from here. And at the bottom, I will paste them. So this show progress will actually make your progress bar visible. This hide progress will make your progress bar as invisible, or you can say view.gone, right? And then finally, show error message will display a error message on your main activity UI, right? So yes, finally, let's start making the API call. So our first step will be use val request equal to, I will use retrofit builder dot build service function. And then I will use request dot call get movies function. So this is where we are calling get movies function, which we have defined over here, right? And as a parameter, we have to pass the API key. Now for the API key, again, I will refer to the gist files. Here you will find API key.txt, where you have to copy the first few three lines of statement companion object, right, which contains a API key. Now at the time you are watching this video, there might be possibility that this key does not work. So in that case, you have to follow these steps over here to create your own API key. So what I will do is I will right now just copy this companion object along with the key and make sure if this key does not work, then you have to create your own key and use that in your code in place of this string value, right? So at the top here, I will add it. And then here I will pass API key. Now this function getMovies basically returns a call object. So I will use val call equal to request.getMovies, right? And using this call object, you can basically control your HTTP request object. That is your HTTP request. So I will use call.nq function. So this nq function is going to create your HTTP request in the background. That is asynchronously. And as a parameter here, you have to use the object declaration of callback. Now this callback is a bit tricky. You have to get it from the package of this retrofit 2. Make sure you select this one only. And as a generic type, you have to use movie response. Within the Lambda, let us implement abstract methods of onResponse and onFailure. Okay, let me maximize my window. Yes, these are the two abstract methods that are present in this interface of callback, right? Now, this onResponse will be executed whenever we get any HTTP response from the server. Now, that response, it doesn't mean we have a success response, right? So it could be a failure as well. So here within this, we can use the if statement and use this response object to check if the response was a success or failure. So for that, I will use response.isSuccessful property. And also we need to check whether the JSON object is null or a valid JSON object. So again, we need to do a conditional check here. So for that, I will use response.body function. Well, this body function is going to return the exact JSON object, right? So if it is not null, then of course our response is a success, right? Along with this property check. And then from this response.body, we are going to get this movie response data class object, right? So here I will use movie response equal to response.body. And then from this movie response object, we are going to get the list of movies finally. Results. And I think what was there? Okay. Great. So yes, again we can call show movies function and pass movies here. So this show movies is actually going to trigger this function over here, which will eventually pass data to the adapter of the recycler view. Fine. Now, if in case we have some error in the response, then in that case, we can show an error message. And for that, I will use right, we are going to show the error message. Now this error message is basically a string resource we have present within our strings.xml file over here. So make sure you add this and also make sure you have this string resource of no internet over here. Fine. So make sure these two resources are in place. So what about this on failure callback? Well, first let me show a error message here as well. Then I will let you know what this function is all about. So here I will use this throwable object, which is t dot the message property. Now this on failure callback will be executed if we have some kind of exception thrown in this API call process, and that error can occur such as while creating an HTTP request, or there was some kind of network interruption while connecting to the server, right? Or even there, if there was some kind of error while processing the HTTP response object so received from that server, from the server. So such errors come under this on failure callback. Now, what about this show error message? What about this else block? Well, as I told you, this on response callback will be executed if we receive some response from the server and that response contains a status code. So if the status code is in the range of 200s, then our response will be successful. But in case our status code is in the range of 300s or 400 or even 500, then in that case, this else block will be executed. So I hope you understand the difference between this else failure over here within on response and this on failure over here. Now again, at the end of for this if clause, we have the else part. That is, if we are not connected to internet, then again, we can show some error message. So here again, I will use show error message, and I will use get resources property dot get string r dot string dot no internet, which is again the string resource present in our strings.xml, right? And at the end, I think we are done with our NQ function, but I think we need to use these functions such as show progress and hide progress. So when should we show the progress bar? Well, before making any request to the server, let us show the progress bar. And once we receive the response from the server, let's hide the progress bar. And also in case of error, let us hide the progress bar. So I hope it is clear why I am doing so, right? When to hide and when to show the progress bar. So I guess we are done now, and let's run our application and let's see what we get. So here the progress bar is visible, which means we are sending a HTTP request to the MoviesDB server. And let's wait for the response. And here we go. As soon as we got the response from the Movies server, we got recycler view inflated with all the movies details. Great, isn't it? Fine. Mission accomplished. So yes, that was it for today's session, and I hope you enjoyed building the application. So in today's workshop, Niharika first walked you through how to implement recycler view, and then I showed you how to use retrofit in your application to make network calls. So yes, that's all for today's workshop. Thank you and have a nice day.